First day. Hello, Teacher Fred. Finally, it's the first day of school. Do we have to wait much longer? I guess not. Great! Now we can start the class.
No! Someone's missing.
You're right. I wonder who it is. Yanko, it's you. Quick, everyone is already in the classroom. Oh, it's your first day of school and you're feeling shy? But you're a very nice Yeti and all your friends are there. You're going to have a great time. That's it. You'll learn new things, you'll stand in front of the blackboard and they'll ask you lots of questions. You'll love it. Come on, Yanko. Everything will be fine. Careful. Of course it's yours. Sit down. Very good, Yanko. You did... Good idea, Pato. That chair looks Yeti-proof. Everything is ready. The class can start. Aren't you excited? Oh, of course, Teacher Fred. Excuse us. You can start now. Come on, Yanko, to the blackboard. You can show us how much you've learned. Yanko?
Yanko, come on. Get out. Come on.
Dictionary. Fantastic idea. Of course, the letter A. Very good. You see how you knew the answer? Music class. One of my favorites. I so enjoy the piano. Those fingertips strumming the guitar. Sorry. Please start. I think it's your turn. Bravo, Yanko! Encore! Encore! You're right. What's that smell? But who brought a herring for their lunch? Well, Yanko, it seems that your herring wasn't such a weird lunch after all. What fun! It's painting class and... Oh, sorry, you're right. It's art class.
Encore!
You don't know what to paint? Look at your friends. They're painting things from their lives, what they see every day. I love it, Yanko. I'll tell you one thing, you won't leave anyone cold with your art. Come on, Yanko, don't give up. Hop, 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 hop. You know, Yanko, you are a top athlete.
Bye, little Mr. Fred.
Of course, Yanko, it's time to go home. So, did you end up enjoying your day at school? You wish the day wasn't over? Your teacher says don't forget your herrings. And don't be late for class tomorrow. Of course there will be school, and you will play with your friends and learn many things tomorrow and the day after and the next and the next. Well, that way you certainly won't be late. Hooray for learning new things, and hooray for going to school. Goodbye, see you next time. To school. Hello, Nina. Well, aren't you happy?
Hey!
Oh, that is a beautiful backpack. It's even got a sticker. Are you going on a trip? To visit a friend? I don't know. Can you give me a hint? That's it, I know. No, wait. I haven't got a clue. Ah, I see. You're going to school. It's the first day of school. What fun. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Nina, Pocoyo wants to know why you're so happy. That's right, it's the first day of school.
A school? Pocoyo, school, no.
But why don't you want to go to school, Pocoyo?
Backpack.
Oh, of course. Pocoyo doesn't have a backpack. Look, Pocoyo, a backpack. Now you can go to school. Hello, Pato. Are you going to school too? Wonderful.
Look, Pato also has a sticker.
Not to school!
What? You still don't want to go? What's the matter, Pocoyo?
Sticker?
You're absolutely right. You don't have a sticker on your backpack and you can't go to school without one. Oh, thank you, Pato. Pato says you're welcome.
Oh!
Pocoyo, school is the other way.
Not to school!
Pocoyo, Elly wants to know why you don't want to go to school.
My stuff!
Oh my, it's true. You don't have crayons or a pencil sharpener or a notebook. Oh dear. Pocoyo really doesn't want to go to school. Pocoyo, I'm sure that it's school.
No.
Then what are you going to do? But everyone else is going to school. Perhaps school would be more fun than playing here by yourself.
No, school boring.
Everyone's having a great time. Don't you want to have fun with your... Oh, the seesaw. And now they're dancing.
No!
Oh, Pocoyo! Theatre, your favourite! Are you sure you don't want to go?
Pocoyo, school, yes.
Now you want to go? Wonderful. That's it. Go on then. Have you changed your mind? What's wrong? Ah, I see. You've said no so many times that now you feel a bit embarrassed. Not to worry, Pocoyo. Your friends are here, and now you're all together at school. What fun! Hooray for friends, and hooray for the first day of school. Goodbye. See you soon. Elly. Hello, caterpillar and baby bird. What are those? Backpacks? I see. You're playing school. What fun. I love school. Elly says, do you have a notebook? Notebooks. Very good. And a pencil?
Yes, you have pencils.
Hello, boys. Elly says, do you want to play school?
Ball.
Oh, well. The Martian Brothers Show. Computer. Suitcase. Pocoyo, Pato, are you sure you don't want to play school? What's this? A story. What fun! Shape shuffle. A circle.
Circle.
A rectangle.
Rectangle.
A triangle.
Triangle.
Circle, rectangle, triangle. What's this, Pocoyo?
Clock.
I see. You've made a clock with circles, rectangles, and triangles.
Ice cream.
An ice cream. Can you tell me the names of the shapes? What are these? And these?
Rectangles.
And these?
Triangles.
Delicious. Circle, rectangle, triangle. They've got pencils, and they're drawing. Elly says you're not ready for school. You need some things. Can you tell me what these are?
They're backpacks.
Can you tell me what these are?
Notebooks.
And what are these?
They're pencils.
Pencils.
Now everyone can play school. What fun!
Let's go to school and bring a notebook. Let's
of colours. Hi, Elly. What are you doing? Painting? Of course. You're painting the house pink, a beautiful colour. Oh, yes, very beautiful. I mean, the most beautiful colour in the whole wide world. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hi!
Ellie's still got quite a lot to paint. Maybe she could use some help. I think perhaps she loves some help. Well, Elly, you've certainly made a very pink house. What's up? There, a nice can of pink. Pato, I'm afraid Ellie's not happy with your colour. Insists you paint the house pink.
No, blue.
Pato's painted your portrait on the wall. But Elly, it can't be that bad to paint with other colours. Pocoyo! Oh no! Pato! Guys, maybe you should... Easy now, guys. Wait a minute. If you don't calm down, you'll never solve this. What a mess. good idea, Elly. Each of you can paint a part. Wonderful! Time. Muck Struck. Hello, Elly. Making a nice cup of tea? Oh, dear. That won't do. Good morning, Pocoyo. Ah, bath time. Aren't you forgetting something? Yuck! Your water's gone bad too. Hello, Pato. Oh, do be careful. Your water has a rather icky color, too. Pato? Something must be done about this nasty water straight away. Very good. You should follow the water pipe to the start. The water in this pond simply must be cleaned up. That poor fish. Oh, we should help him. Very good, Pocoyo. You certainly are collecting lots of rubbish. Wonderful, Pato. This pond will be clean in no time. Everyone. But I'm afraid the water is still brown. Done, every one of you. Well done indeed. Ah, what a perfect morning on the nice, clean pond. And it's all thanks to all your hard work, guys. Whole lot of trouble. Pocoyo and Elly and Pato.
Hi.
What's that you're playing?
Marbles.
Let's see. You need to get your marble into that small hole right there in the middle, right? And how is everyone doing? What about you, Pocoyo? That's a special black super marble. Oh, I'm sorry, Pocoyo. You almost had it. Well, whose turn is it now? Wait! What's happening?
Yay!
Yes, Pocoyo, but how did your marble move all on its own? I think you've discovered a black hole. It'll suck up anything nearby. And you know what that means, don't you? Pocoyo, this is no time for dancing. Now come on, get away from that hole. Good idea, Pato. Grab that tree. Hold on, everyone. This is rather funny, isn't it? But I'm afraid we have to get Elly out somehow. Can anyone switch on the light? Well, that's a relief. Everything seems to be fine, except for one minor detail. All the colors are reversed. Pato, you're not yellow anymore.
Now you're purple. And Elly, now you're green. You'd like everything to go back to normal, wouldn't you? Well, maybe there's a way. Are you thinking about how to get back to your world, Pocoyo? Well, you know, maybe your black super marble is the key. Maybe it can take you back home. Yes, Elly, that's it. In this world, Pocoyo's black marble would be white. Now what? There you go, a white hole. Jump in, everyone. But Pato, don't you want to be yellow again? This certainly isn't your world. You're all made of paper. You'd better find that marble. Good job, Pato. Oh, my. You're balloons now. You're back home, guys. You didn't leave anything behind, did you? That's a good question, Pato. What should you do with it? It looks like Pocoyo has an idea. A rocket? Oh, I see. Well, then I'd better start a countdown. Ready? 3, 2, 1, blast off! Well, look at that. It's a magical nighttime. See you soon. Hello, everyone!
Hi!
My, what a beautiful garden! You have tomatoes, and lettuce, and what is that exactly?
Carrots!
Carrots, of course! It's a delicious-looking garden. Hi, Elly.
Elly. Search, Elly.
Pocoyo wants you to search for a word on your computer.
Plant.
To plant. Elly is searching for to plant. It's Pato. He is planting a seed. Wow. Fantastic!
Mar. Water!
Pocoyo would like you to search for to water. Look! Pato is watering his flowers.
Thank you, Elly!
Yes, thank you, Elly. Well done! What's that, Elly? You say it's time to pick your vegetables? Elly says you should pick the tomatoes first. Your tomatoes! They're gone! Look! Now the lettuce is moving! At least your carrots are still there. Oops! Quick! Follow the vegetables! Oh, dear.
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
It's a spider!
Spider!
A spider. Right.
Hello.
This is very strange. Can you tell me what this is?
It's lettuce.
And what is this?
Tomato.
It's a tomato.
And this?
It's a carrot.
That's right. It's a carrot. And it's moving. Look, it's an ant. It's a lot of ants. It seems our little friends didn't take your vegetables. They just wanted to make a salad for you. And what a delicious salad it is! Hi, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hi.
Do you know what those are? Hi, Elly.
Elly!
Whoa!
What have you got there? Ah, you have some things to recycle. Bottles. Bottles go in the bottle bin. Cans go in the bin for cans.
Cans!
Newspapers. Newspapers go in the newspaper bin.
Me!
Now Pocoyo is going to recycle.
Pocoyo's Fairy Tales.
Hello, Pocoyo. What's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, at the ant's house, the ant and the dinosaur had a party. The end! Oops. After the party, the ant's house was very messy. So the ant and the dinosaur had to sweep and wash the dishes and vacuum. The house was very, very clean. So they had another party. But then the house was messy again. So they had to sweep and wash the dishes and vacuum. And the house was clean again. The end.
Recycle.
Fred, Pocoyo wants to recycle your things. Fred says he wants these things.
Recycle.
Recycling is good, Fred. It's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, play with the ball. That's it. Play with the ball. Playing with the ball is fun. Fred says, draw. Come on. Let's draw! Fred says, take pictures! That's it! Take pictures! Well done! Fred says, that's all! Time to recycle! Can you tell Fred what goes in this bin?
Bottles!
Bottles! That's right! Can you tell Fred what goes in this bin?
Cans!
Cans! Great! Can you tell Fred what goes in this bin?
Newspapers!
Newspapers. Right! Recycling! What fun!
Ah!
Hi, Pocoyo.
Hi.
What are those things?
Paintbrush, palette.
Oh, I see. You're painting. What a beautiful painting. Hi, Elly. What are you doing? You're taking pictures. Terrific. Hello, baby bird and caterpillar. What are you doing? You're making a sculpture. Wonderful. And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. A camera? A paintbrush? Now, Pocoyo.
Palette. Bye.
Well, good night. Hello, Pato. Look, it's a museum. Can you tell Pato what that is?
A sculpture!
Right, a sculpture. You don't like it? Oh dear. Can you tell Pato what that is?
A painting!
It's Pocoyo's painting!
Painting!
You don't like the painting? Can you tell Pato what those are?
Pictures!
Pictures. You don't like the sculpture, the painting, or the pictures?
Animals, dot to dot.
Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
It's a kangaroo!
A kangaroo. Pato, I think you hurt your friend's feelings. Well, maybe you can show them how to do it. What's that you say, Pato? It's too difficult? Elly says your painting is wonderful, Pato. You're all talented. Hooray! Hello, Elly. Oh, you have a new doll. It has two arms and two legs and a head. Wonderful. Hello, boys. Will you guard Ellie's doll?
Professor Pato.
Hello, friends. Now, class, pay attention. Professor Pato says this is a hand. A hand has fingers. This is a foot. A foot has toes. Baby bird, can you tell us what that is? Can you tell Baby Bird what that is?
It's a foot!
It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
Foot!
Wonderful! Now we've all learned about fingers and toes. Thank you, Professor Pato.
Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
Oh, dear. Pato, be careful. This is not good. Oh, no! Pocoyo, Pato, don't! Oh. Pocoyo, is that a good idea? Cake. Thank you. Poor Elly.
Pretzel!
And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, paint. That's it. Everyone paint. Painting is fun. Fred says, take a picture. That's it. Get a camera and take a picture. Fred says, play an instrument. That's it. Playing an instrument is fun. Fred says, that's all. We have all the pieces. Can you tell me what that is?
It's a head!
It's a head!
And what are those?
Legs!
They're legs!
And those?
Arms!
Arms, that's right. Ah, let's fix it. Let's see. Two legs and two arms and a head. Terrific! You've fixed it! Great! Baby bird. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi. Up.
What are you doing?
Up and down.
You're playing up and down.
Down. Up.
Can you down. Say up and down?
Up. Down.
Do you understand up and down now, baby bird? No?
Professor Otto.
Now, class, pay attention. Professor Pato says, this is a planet, and this is an alien. The alien is above the planet, above. Now the alien is below the planet, below. Now he's behind the planet, behind. Now he's in front of the planet, in front of. Baby Bird, it's your turn. Can you tell Baby Bird where the alien is?
In front!
The alien is in front of the planet.
Hmm. It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say.
In front!
Wonderful! Now we've all learned about positions. Thank you, Professor Pato. Lesson approved by Professor Pato.
What's this? A slide! This will explain up and down. Is Pocoyo going up or down?
Up! He's going up!
That's right. He's going up the ladder. And now, is Pocoyo going up or down?
Whee! He's going down!
Whee! Down the slide! Ready to go up, baby bird? Up you go! Down you go! Now do you understand up and down, baby bird? Oh dear. Number our menu!
6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ah, time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 8 carrots. Very good.
8 carrots!
Oh dear. Well, how about 8 cherries instead?
8 cherries!
8 cherries. Ah, poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
8 hearts!
That's right, 8. The vamoosh. This should really explain up and down.
Up.
Can you tell Baby Bird which way they're going?
Up! They're going up!
That's right. Up, up, up!
Down!
Can you tell Baby Bird which way they're going now?
Down! They're going down!
That's right. Down! Well, Baby Bird, do you understand up and down now? You do? Wonderful! Good job, Pocoyo! What's that, Baby Bird? You say you understand up and down, but Caterpillar doesn't? Oh dear, it's going to be a long day.
Up and down. Up and down. Above. Below. In front. Behind.
Hello, Pato. What a lovely living room. There's a sofa, a table, a rug, and a TV. Wonderful. Oh, look. Your friends are here. Pato, that wasn't nice.
The Martian Brothers Show!
TV. Radio.
Radio, 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 radio.
Radio, it's a radio.
Phone. Ah, popcorn. Delicious.
Hello!
Pato, your friends are here. Where is Caterpillar?
The table.
She's on the table.
Where is Pocoyo?
He's on the sofa.
And where is Lula? That's right.
Wheel of Colors. Welcome to the show. Here we go. And today's color is... purple! All right, let's all look for something purple. Go! Something purple. All right, let's see your pictures. A purple ball. A purple umbrella. And a purple cup. Good job! Now keep looking for purple things. A purple car. Perfect. A purple aubergine. Beautiful. And this, do you know what it is? Purple alien! Hooray for purple!
Pato, that's not nice. They are your friends. I wonder where your friends are, Pato. They aren't having much fun. Pocoyo, Pato would like you to sit on the sofa. That's right, Lula, sit on the rug. And Caterpillar sits on the table. What fun! Now everyone can watch TV together.
Welcome to my living room. My friends have come to be here with me. We all watch the TV. One sits on the table, one lies on the rug, some sit on the sofa. Sofa, one sits on the table, one lies on the rug. We all watch the TV.
It's Pocoyo. I wonder what he's doing. He has a whistle, a traffic light, and a crossing. Pocoyo is a traffic policeman. Fantastic! And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. A bicycle?
Bicycle!
A bus? Pocoyo.
Car. Bye.
Car!
Well, good night. Oh dear, no one is paying attention to the traffic light or the whistle. Can you tell me what that is?
It's a whistle!
A whistle, right. And that?
A traffic light!
Right. A red light means stop. A green light means go. Uh-oh. Oh, dear. Can you tell Pato what that is?
A crossing.
When you cross the street, you must use the crossing. Now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, sit. That's it. Everyone sit. 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 Fred says, stand up. Stand up. Everyone stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Fred says, lie down. Lie down. Lie down. Let's all lie down. Fred says, that's all. Oh, dear. This looks bad. Pato says, please be our traffic policeman, Pocoyo. You need to pay attention to the traffic light, the crossing, and the whistle. Now you know why you need a traffic policeman. Much better.
If you want to cross the street, you need to use a crossing. And then look at the traffic lights and listen to the whistle of the traffic policeman.
Traffic light! Crossing! Whistle!
If you want to cross the street, you need to use a crossing. And then look at the traffic lights and listen to the whistle of the traffic policeman.